Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the topic is the semiconductors. Semiconducting materials are the materials whose electrical resistivity or a conductivity lies in between the insulator and the conductor. It is in the order of 10 power minus 4 to 0.5 ohm meter. A semiconducting material are classified into two types based on the addition of impurities. They are intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor can also be called as a pure semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor are also be called as impure semiconductor. Now we are going to see the intrinsic semiconducting material. In intrinsic semiconducting material, we are going to measure the total carrier concentration of this medium, intrinsic semiconductor. To find the total carrier concentration of an intrinsic semiconductor, we are going to measure the carrier concentration of the electrons in the conduction band, and we have to measure the carrier concentration of the holes in the valence band. So to find the carrier concentration of an intrinsic semiconductor, that is to find the total carrier concentration of this intrinsic medium, we have to know the carrier concentration of the electrons in the conduction band, and we have to know the carrier concentration of the holes in the valence band. So to find the carrier concentration of the electrons and to find the carrier concentration of the holes in the conduction and the valence band, so let us consider a pure semiconducting material, example silicon. We have taken silicon as an example, and here we have shown the structure of the silicon. So from the structure we can say that there is no free electron availability. So when there is no free electrons available in the structure, then the conduction band is empty. When the electrons are in the covalent bonds, when the electrons are presented inside the covalent bond, these covalent bonded electrons are called valency electrons. So these valency electrons are nothing but the valence band electrons. So we can say that for the pure semiconducting material, example silicon, when the field is not applied to this material, there is no free electrons. It means that the conduction band is empty. All the electrons are in the covalent bonding. It means that all the electrons are in the valence state, and the Fermi level lies exactly at the middle. Since the Fermi level locates at the middle, the Fermi level locates in between the conduction band and the valency band. It means that the Fermi level will present in between the hole concentration and the electron concentration. So this is the just nature of the Fermi level. The Fermi level always lies exactly at the middle between the hole and the electron concentration. Here we are having entirely the hole concentration. Here we are having entirely the electron concentration. So we can say that the Fermi level is located at the middle of the conduction band and the valency band. So when the field is not applied to the semiconducting material, all the electrons are in the valency state. The conduction band is empty. The Fermi level locates at the middle. When the field is applied to this intrinsic semiconducting material, then the electrons in the valency band gains that energy. After acquiring the maximum amount of energy, the electrons from the valency band goes to the conduction band by creating holes here. So when the temperature reaches the maximum, under maximum temperature, we can see that the concentration of the electrons in the conduction band is equal to the concentration of the holes in the valency band. When these concentrations are equal, so the Fermi level locates at the middle. So with this, we are going to measure the carrier concentration of the electrons in the conduction band of an intrinsic semiconductor. And also we are going to measure the carrier concentration of the holes in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor. Now we are going to find the electron concentration and we are going to find the hole concentration. After measuring the values of electron concentration, that is NE, and after the measuring the values of hole concentration, that is NH, we are going to find the total carrier concentration of the intrinsic semiconductor, that is NI. We are going to measure the density of holes in the valence band of an intrinsic semiconductor. As we all know from the theory, we have considered intrinsic semiconductor. In intrinsic semiconductor, when the field is zero, when T is equal to zero Kelvin, under this assumption, all the electrons are in the valence state. The conduction band is empty. The Fermi level locates at the center. When the field is applied to the intrinsic semiconducting material, that is when T is not equal to zero Kelvin, under this consideration, the electrons are in the conduction band, the holes are in the valency band. So we are going to measure the holes concentration in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor. So in the previous lecture, we have measured the density of electrons in the conduction band of an intrinsic semiconductor. And now we are going to measure the density of holes in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor. Let's start our derivation. Here, to find the carrier concentration of the holes in the valency band, we are going to consider the general equation, that is integral dNH equal to NH equal to integral minus infinity to EV Z of E dE into 1 minus F of E. Here, minus infinity to EV are the limits. So these are the limits for the valency band, the lower region of the valency band and the upper region of the valency band. So this lower region is minus infinity, the upper region is EV. So these lower and the upper region are considered here as an limits, that is minus infinity to EV. Z of E into DE and 1 minus F of E are the density of a state and Fermi distribution function. So according to density of state, the total number of the electrons available in the energy state is already defined. It's given in condition number 2. Similarly, from the Fermi distribution function, the total number of the electrons in the energy intervals is also already defined and it's given in condition number 4. So let's see the derivation. To find the density of holes in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor, our first equation is NH equal to integral minus E to EV Z of E into DE into 1 minus F of E, where Z of E into DE equal to 4 pi by H cube 2 M 3 by 2 E power half into DE. Here, this above condition is modified, that is the term M is modified as MH star and the term E is modified as EV minus E. The reason, M is the mass of an electron, but here we are discussing about the hole concentration and moreover the electrons are now in the conduction band, the holes are in the valency band. So we are discussing about the effective mass. So the effective mass of a hole in the valency band can be written as mh star. So here E is the total energy of the medium. According to semiconductor, this E can be written as EV minus E. So the equation 2 is further modified as Z of E into DE 4 pi by H cube to MH star 3 by 2 EV minus E 1 by 2 into DE, condition number 3. So to solve this equation number 1, we have measured the first parameter, that is Z of E into DE. The second parameter from equation number 1 is 1 minus f of e. Since f of e is the probability of electron occupancy, that is according to Fermi distribution function, the electrons in the energy states is given by 1 by 1 plus e power e minus ef by kBT. So this equation is for the electron concentration. But our consideration is the hole concentration in the valency band. So for the hole concentration from the Fermi distribution function, we can write 1 minus f of e into dE or 1 minus f of e. Then 1 minus f of e equal to 1 minus 1 by e power, that is 1 minus f of e is equal to 1 minus 1 by 1 plus e power e minus f by kBT. So this equation 4 is further simplified, and we can write 1 minus f of e equal to 1 plus e power e minus f by kBT minus 1 divided by 1 plus e power ef minus e minus f by kBT. So this equation is further simplified by cancellation, and we can write 1 minus f of e equal to e power e minus f by kBT by 1 plus e power e minus f by kBT. So this equation is for the density of holes in the valency band from the Fermi distribution function. So this condition is further simplified and return as 1 minus f of e is equal to e power e minus ef by kBT by 1. Here the term 1 plus e power e minus ef by kBT is taken as a 1 because the hole concentration is more than the electron concentration in the medium. So for the presence of the hole, we can write 1 plus e power e minus ef by kBT is equal to 1. Therefore, the above term 1 minus f of e equal to e power e minus ef by kBT by 1 plus e power e minus ef by kBT becomes 1 minus f of e equal to e power e minus ef by kBT. So the final condition is condition number 5. The conditions 5 and 3 are substituted in equation 1. So we can write NH is equal to integral minus infinity to EV 4 pi by H cube to MH star 3 by 2 EV minus E by half. Then E power E minus EF by kBT into DE. Condition number 6. Now, from this condition number 6, we are getting the constant parameter out. So we can write NH is equal to 4 pi by H cube to MH star 3 by 2. Here, this exponential term E power E minus EF by kBT is simplified, and from this, we are just getting E power minus EF by kBT outside the integration. So we can write 4 pi by h cube to mh star 3 by 2 e power minus EF by KBT, then integral minus infinity to EV, EV minus E 1 by 2, E power E by KBT into D, condition number 7. Now, to solve these integration 7, we are going to assume that EV minus E is equal to X. When we consider EV minus E is equal to X, from this we can write E is equal to EV minus X. On differentiating this term, we can get D is equal to minus DX. So we can change the parameters. To solve this integration number 7, we are going to change the parameter. We are going to make this into the simple form. We are removing the E term and we are going to introduce the X term. So the value EV minus E is equal to X, assumed as an X. So we can write E is equal to EV minus X. So these are DE is also changed as minus DX. Now we have to change the limits. Initially we are having minus infinity. This minus infinity is substituted in this condition EV minus E. So we get X is equal to infinity. See, when E is equal to minus infinity, then EV minus, then minus infinity is equal to X. That is EV plus infinity is equal to X. X is equal to infinity. We can change the lower limit, minus infinity into plus infinity. Now, when E is equal to EV, then EV minus EV is equal to 0, then X becomes 0. So we can change EV into 0. So the total change is made and we can modify equation 7 as NH is equal to 4 pi by H cube to MH star whole power 3 by 2 E power minus EF by KBT integral. Here minus infinity becomes plus infinity, EV becomes 0. This term EV minus X becomes EV minus E becomes an X. So this term E power E, it becomes EV minus X by KBT, DE becomes minus DX. Here we are having a negative sign in the differentiation integration term. So to remove this negative sign, we can interchange the limits. By interchanging the limits, we can just omit this negative sign. And we can see that from condition number 8, NH is equal to 4 pi by H cube, 2 MH star 3 by 2, E power EV minus EF by KBT, integral, infinity becomes 0, 0 becomes infinity. We have changed the limit. When we change the limit, then the sign will omit. We can just eliminate the sign and remove the sign. So we write X 1 by 2, E power the same term, EV minus X by KBT into DX. Here what we did, E power EV minus X by KBT is simplified and we have taken the term E power EV by KBT outside the integration. So we have written here as NH is equal to 4 pi by H cube, 2 MH star, 3 by 2, E power EV minus EF. See, here we are having E power minus EF. Here we are having plus E power plus EV. So this term, when we take out, it becomes E power EV minus EF by KBT, then integral 0 to infinity, X 1 by 2, E power minus X by KBT into DX. Now, we are going to consider a mathematical term, that is by using the gamma function, the value of this above integral is given by KBT whole power 3 by 2, pi 1 by 2 by 2. See, by using the gamma function, we solved this above integral, and for this above integral, the solution is KBT whole power 3 by 2, pi 1 by 2 by 2. Then substitute the value 9 in 8, we get NH equal to 4 pi by H cube to MH star 3 by 2 E power EV minus E by KBT KBT all power 3 by 2, pi 1 by 2 by 2. So what we are just shown in the integration that we have eliminated. For this, we have substituted the result by using gamma function. So we get a condition like this. On further solving this term, finally we get NH is equal to 2 into 2 pi MH star KBT by H square whole power 3 by 2 e power EV minus EF by KBT assigned as condition number 10. So we can say that the density of the holes in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor or the carrier concentration of the holes in the valency band of an intrinsic semiconductor is NH is equal to 2 into 2 pi MH star KBT by H square whole power 3 by 2 e power EV minus EF by KBT. So this is the final equation for the hole concentration in the valency band. This is the same equation we can compare it with the electron concentration and we can show the difference. See, in electron concentration, instead of NH, we have written there NE. Then this RHS term for electron concentration is 2 into 2 pi. Here we have written MH star, there we write ME star KBT by H square whole power 3 by 2. Here in whole concentration, we have written E power EV minus EF by KBT, but in electron concentration, we mentioned E power EF minus EC. E power EF minus EC by KBT. So there is no huge difference in the result part when compared with the electron and the hole concentrations. There is only just a small changes, but we have to go through this derivation properly. So that's all for the hole concentration. Thank you.